go back to the Gospel of John, John 1:14. And here's what the Message translation says. Eugene Peterson wrote it this way. He said, the Word, again, that's Jesus, the Word became flesh and blood, and say it with me, what? Moved into the neighborhood. I think it's very interesting that Jesus moves in the neighborhood and not into the temple. Because if you think about it, if God is going to be moving in, where's the one place you're going to look for him? You're going to go look for him in the temple. But Jesus, when it came to his ministry, he didn't spend most of his time in the temple. He spent most of his time in neighborhoods, in homes, going across the street, spending time with people. Now, there's a difference, big difference between moving into a house and moving into the neighborhood like Jesus did. Like when you move into a house, you move into a house, that's the place where you eat, it's the place where you sleep, it's where you watch Netflix, get caught up on Selena, you know, you're hanging out with your family. It's very inward focused. Not bad, it's just about you and your family. But when you move into a neighborhood, that's very outward focused. Think of it like this. Think of it like a cruise ship experience. If you've ever been on a cruise, but when you book a cruise, you don't book it for the room. You could care less about the room because you're not going to be spending any time in the room. Laura and I went on a cruise several years ago, and I didn't care what room we were in. I want to know what was happening on the cruise because I'm going to spend most of my time outside. In fact, and you do the craziest things on cruises. You're eating at midnight. You're going to the weirdest shows. Laura and I ended up in a karaoke contest. Laura and I were doing karaoke. I'd never forget. We did Love Shack. Remember Love Shack? Love Shack, baby, Love Shack. I thought I was going to be amazing at it, and wow. I mean, even the whales were struggling. It was like, and that was just Laura and I, not the whales. I mean, it was bad. But so when you think about it, Jesus calls us to move into the neighborhood. We're not just supposed to move into a house. But like Jesus, we're supposed to move into the neighborhood. Now, I'm not suggesting by any means that you should have a karaoke night, but do you know your neighbors? Do you know who you're? Do you know them beyond, the people that crank Lynyrd Skynyrd till 1 a.m. in the morning? Not that I have neighbors like that. Not that I know anyone like that. I mean, do you know the person at work beyond she's always late? Do you know the parent on the ball team other than the one who complains about their kids playing time is always yelling at the refs? Like, do you know your neighbors? Because Jesus moved in on mission. He was very intentional about going across the street, going next door, sitting around tables, getting to know people. In fact, there's a story in Luke about Zacchaeus. And Zacchaeus, if you don't know that story, is basically Zacchaeus. Think of the neighbor you don't like and you wish they would move. That was Zacchaeus. Nobody liked Zacchaeus. But Jesus went and ate around Zacchaeus' table.